Hi there, I'm James White and I'm the founder of InTouch CRM. And my passion and most amazing feeling that I get is seeing my customers hit their sales targets. So here are 10 things I'm going to tell you that you need to do and put in place if you're going to hit the new sales targets you set for 2018. Step number one is define the actual time period that you're going to measure. Everyone's business is slightly different. You might have a weekly business, a monthly or quarterly business, but the most important thing is firstly is to define the target time set that you're going to work within. Whether that's monthly, weekly, quarterly, it doesn't matter. Have a clear thing that says I'm going to measure myself on this time basis. Point number two is define the actual metric that you're going to measure. What's key in your business? Is it revenue? Is it profit? Is it the number of customers? There'll be different metrics that work specifically well in your business compared to others. But the most important thing is you pick one and use that as a method in which to measure your success over the course of 2018. Point number three, outline this target and compare it to where you were maybe the previous month or more importantly, the previous year. Look at the difference between those two figures and basically ask yourself, is it realistic? If you were at 100, for example, of a figure in last year, is it realistic to get to 200 this year? Look and compare where you were and see whether actually the difference you've got and the growth that you've put in place is realistic. A great tip to be able to identify whether that growth is realistic is have a search on how quickly your industry's growing. If your industry's growing by 10%, then why should you expect to grow by 50%? Look at what others are doing in your industry and make sure that your targets are realistic in this respect. Tip number four, and it's key that you do this, is do you know your average sales order value? Of course, there may be some products and services that you sell that depend and differ in price. But over the course of all of your customers, look at an average of the value that you sell. Maybe the average is £500, £1,000, £10,000, whatever it is, make sure you look at that average order value so you can give an estimate as to how many deals of that type you're going to need to bring in to actually hit your target. Point number five, define how long it normally takes you to convert a prospect into a customer. And by that, we mean the moment you engage with that prospect through to the moment they sign the paperwork or pay you the money for your service. Measure the time it takes from start to finish so that you can identify the average length of time it takes you to close a piece of business. And therefore, you can use this within our modeling and plans over the course of the year to ensure you're hitting your targets. If you don't know your times or you don't measure your times, then start doing that now. It's a key metric in your business. Point number six, define your sales process from start to finish. Most businesses make the mistake of trying to close business too early, and most prospects need to go on a step-by-step journey with you and your company before they become a customer. So you need to define what those steps are and be clear about what each one looks at so that you can identify how many prospects you're moving through each individual process. Step number seven, you've got to be able to identify your conversion rate between stage to stage. I talk to a lot of businesses who tell me that they win every bit of business that they engage with. Being honest, I don't believe them. And the reality is, if you're a business owner that thinks that, you're probably kidding yourself. We all know that even the people that come to us, the prospects that engage with us, we invariably never convert 100% of those people. We'll get people to different stages and we'll have a different conversion rate for each stage in that process from people that we've sent proposals to, that we've done demos to, etc., etc. You need to be able to measure how many people are getting through each individual stage in your process. And if you don't do that, you're not going to then know which areas of your business you're weaker at and which you need to focus on. Now you've identified the steps above and you've identified the sales process, the average order value, and the percentage of people that you get from each individual stage to stage, what you'll be able to do is to be able to define the amount of prospects that you need to engage with in that month to hit a target. Let's give that example. If I know that I take 25% of my prospects through four stages in my cycle, I know I'm going to need 100 prospects at the start in order to hit a target if that target I've identified is 25. So I've got to take those people through that journey because I know I'm going to get some people that fall by the wayside. And I'm going to have to ensure to hit that target that I bring that right amount of people on board. You need to make sure that you identify the amount of prospects that you need. And the key thing to do that is to be able to see what's required in order to be able to hit that overall number or that target that you've set. If you do that, you've got a great chance of hitting those sales targets. Step number 9 is if you've identified how many prospects that you need, you're then going to need to look at how many marketing leads that you're going to need to put into your funnel at the top of your funnel in order to be able to move those prospects through that funnel. The reality is, if you need 100 people, for example, in order to go to the stage, the next stage, and the next stage, you're probably going to need 200 or 300 people at the start of the process, because not everyone that comes to your website that interacts with your company is going to ask information straight away. Some of those people are going to maybe have a little look at you. They're going to look, search on social media or have a look around who your company is. They're going to look at reviews before they actually engage with you as a company. So identifying how many people you need at the top of your lead pipeline will enable you then to be able to see how many you need to move through your individual prospect stages. And the final stage of this is, once you've now identified the amount of marketing leads that you need in order to be able to convert into prospects, in order to move between stage to stage to hit the target numbers that you've set, what you can now start to do is work backwards and define how many leads you need per day, per week, per month in order to hit that sales target. The reality is, the target that you've got here is not going to be hit unless you have some miraculous thing that happens, unless you go through the process that I've talked through. And the process that we've engaged here is the best way in order to ensure that the targets you've set are going to be delivered. I don't want you at the end of 2018 complaining that you've had another bad year. I want you to make sure the targets you've set are realistic and you can really go and make them happen and get that amazing feeling from winning and having the success that you want. So there's my 10 stage tips in order to be able to hit your sales targets for 2018. What me and my team have done is also created a really simple guide that talks you through how to do this. And the guide will actually enable you to go through a process and create your own sales identity and targets to make sure that you hit those for 2018. I'm also offering to work with 5 companies over the course of the next few weeks to help ensure that they hit their targets. And I'd love your company to be one of them. So if you're keen to ensure that 2018 is a better year than this year, and that you want to ensure that the targets that you set are going to be hit, take that action now. I believe in you and your business and what you can achieve. Believe in yourself. Make the decision that you're not going to let 2018 be another year that passes you by. Join with me. It's going to be a brilliant, fun adventure, and I'm going to make sure that you have the best year you've ever had in business.